All right. Well, good morning. Thank you all for being here. I'd like to begin by thanking our partners who are here today. Of course, State Police Director Brennan Kelly, Chief Mitchell Davis, past president of the Illinois Association of Chiefs of Police, and Hazel Kress, Police Chief Leo Schmitz from Cook County Sheriff's Office, Dan Katowski, my former colleague in the legislature and Executive Director of Kids Above All, Kim Smith, Director of Programs at the University of Chicago Crime Lab, Casey Atayero, Chief External Affairs Officer at the Joyce Foundation, and Valerie Burgess from Moms Demand Action. 3.5 years ago, when I took helm as Attorney General, one of my priorities was to try to work comprehensively, notwithstanding limited prosecutorial jurisdiction, on reducing gun violence. We've made contributions by stepping in sometimes for local prosecutors to prosecute murders, armed robberies, gun trafficking cases. We've expanded our crime victims services to better respond to gun violence survivors. We have enthusiastically accepted a new responsibility given to us by the legislature to partner with the Illinois State Police on prosecuting gun-related crimes on our state roadways. We've partnered with Secret Services National Threat Assessment Center on conducting trainings to help prevent mass shootings in schools, places of worships, and other places of mass gathering. And we've trained on our state's red flag law. But one of the top priorities coming into the office for me was to try to develop a state-of-the-art crime gun tracing platform, because it's one of the most effective ways to investigate gun trafficking and straw purchasing. Tracing guns recovered after they are used in a crime can help identify the purchaser, but also co-conspirators and witnesses. On top of that, crime gun tracing can provide a better look at trends and patterns of how guns are finding their ways into the hands of people we know will do bad with them. While this critical data is maintained by the ATF and available to law enforcement agencies, the process for these law enforcement agencies is really onerous to go through these records. For instance, federal law prevents crime gun records from being digitized, meaning records are still stored in paper form. Instead of being able to search and analyze data immediately, law enforcement agencies that request tracing data must sort through paper records and spreadsheets to get basic information on the source of crime guns. This is often a valuable time loss. So we worked in collaboration with Everytown for Gun Safety, and we hired data scientists, some consultants, to help us develop a system that will modernize and simplify the process of analyzing crime gun traces for Illinois law enforcement agencies. The system will be made available through the Illinois State Police, along with other tools that they have developed to help law enforcement agencies solve gun crimes. Crime Gun Connect will allow law enforcement agencies in Illinois to access critical crime gun trace records more efficiently than ever before. This platform will allow law enforcement agencies to crack down on illegal gun trafficking by analyzing firearms recovered when they are used in a crime. Crime Gun Connect is a tool for law enforcement that is informed by law enforcement. In developing the platform, we incorporated feedback that we received in a prior version of a tracing tool. Crime Gun Connect contains over 100,000 crime gun trace records from approximately 200 law enforcement agencies in Illinois, dating back to 2009. The platform also incorporates sophisticated mapping technology as well as an algorithm that helps identify the individuals most likely involved in trafficking. In short, Crime Gun Connect will take trace records that have always been paper-based and make them available in a format that allows searching, sorting, and filtering in a quick manner. While we cannot show you a Crime Gun Connect itself in sort of live form, I'm going to bring up real quick Adam Braun, my executive deputy, to do a quick demonstration so that you can get a sense of the data that law enforcement can access.
Thank you, Attorney General Raoul. As the Attorney General mentioned, shortly after taking office, he directed us to establish a crime gun tracing portal. And the goal in creating this portal was to close a gap created through the advocacy efforts of groups such as the NRA. They've been able to successfully attach riders to federal appropriations bills that prevent the ATF from maintaining these records in a digital format. The records are literally kept on paper and stored at a facility in West Virginia. As a result, there is no comprehensive electronic database available to law enforcement when they want to search the provenance of a gun used in the commission of a crime. So as the Attorney General stated, we've developed Crime Gun Connect to address that problem. The system contains over 100,000 crime gun trace records from nearly 200 Illinois law enforcement agencies dating back to 2009. And though the ATF maintains these records on paper, there is the ability to request and receive crime gun trace records electronically. And agencies can further opt into something called collective data sharing. And when they do so, they share their records with other law enforcement agencies in the state. And that's how we've built this system. As you can see on the monitor, we've built a system that allows law enforcement to search for information the same way we all Google information every day. Rather than sorting through piles and piles of paper records, law enforcement can enter basic information into the search box to immediately get records relevant to their investigation. The platform also incorporates sophisticated mapping technology. While the recovery data that populates the system is limited to the state of Illinois, we're able to use the system to build a nationwide picture as to the source of crime guns that are used in the commission of crimes in Illinois. The system also includes sophisticated filtering options and algorithms that elevate those firearms most likely to have been trafficked or the result of straw purchasing. As you can see here, the system will allow law enforcement to filter by geographic range, types of crime, time to crime, and certain indicators that we know to be likely indicia of trafficking and straw purchasing. Each one of those flags on the screen represents a discrete recovery. And when a law enforcement officer is at their workstation, they can click on any one of those flags to get the full records associated with that crime gun recovery. You'll see here on the bottom, we have an individual identified as straw buyer. That person has purchased 9 firearms outside of Indianapolis that quickly were recovered in the city of Chicago. You see that the firearms were purchased over a 19-day period in 2009 from 3 dealers and recovered from 9 different possessors. To us, that's a clear indication of someone who's engaged in trafficking and straw purchasing. You'll also see that the recoveries were in a very discrete area on the west side of Chicago. We believe that this is, again, indicative of a clear gun trafficking operation. As the Attorney General mentioned, we've started rolling this platform out to law enforcement throughout the state. It's going to reside in a one-stop shop maintained by the Illinois State Police, where law enforcement officers will be able to access this amongst many resources to fighting gun trafficking and straw purchasing in the state of Illinois. We hope that law enforcement will use this as a tool to help conduct more effective and efficient investigations into the source of crime guns in Illinois.
Thanks, Adam. You know, at this point, I want to bring Director Kelly up, and before I bring him up, I just want to say that what a pleasure it's been to collaborate with Director Kelly on a whole host of things. We share responsibility for coordinating law enforcement statewide, and we have our challenges within our state, but to the extent that we're working together as law enforcement and we have the most state-of-the-art tools, we can put a big dent in the issues that we have. So I bring up Director Kelly.
Thank you, Attorney General, and right back at you. The cooperation that we have between the Illinois State Police as well as our local chiefs and sheriffs and the Attorney General's office is absolutely critical, and this is just another example of that cooperative effort. Illegally obtained firearms are clearly driving the violence in our state, the violence that robs children of their future and families of those whom they love and traumatizes whole communities, sometimes for generations, fueling more violence. Everyday law enforcement officers in our state, including the proud men and women of the Illinois State Police, work tirelessly to seek out illegal firearms, some stolen, some used in crimes, and some with no serial numbers, privately made firearms, more commonly known as ghost guns. Their lives are also threatened, and their lives are taken by this gun violence. Gun violence is a complicated phenomenon with no single solution, and pushing back is often a game of inches. Success is achieved through the combination of many tools and sustained, diligent crime-fighting efforts. So we utilize every resource at our disposal to prevent the illegal possession and use of firearms. To solve crimes committed using firearms, we rely more and more on technology and increasing information sharing opportunities to expand the reach and coordination of law enforcement agencies and the justice system. With the technology and resources available today, we share intelligence on crimes not only with neighboring law enforcement agencies, but with agencies across the state and across the country to help solve crime. After the Henry Pratt shooting, the Illinois State Police provided detailed gun intelligence through a law enforcement portal that we've expanded over the years into a one-stop shop where law enforcement can go to get intelligence for crime gun-related enforcement using a variety of tools. And thanks to the leadership of the Attorney General, the portal now includes access to Crime Gun Connect. Almost 700 law enforcement agencies in Illinois use this portal, and those agencies, indeed any police department in the state, can access and utilize this new tool. Since taking office, the Governor and the General Assembly, with bipartisan support, have given the direction and resources to rebuild the Illinois State Police and laid the foundation for law enforcement to pursue a better strategy for combating illegal firearms. Through stable budgeting and fixing long-standing weaknesses, we're bringing the state's firearms background check out of the 1960s and into the 2020s. For example, from 2020 through the end of April of this year, the end of the first quarter, the Illinois State Police stopped more than 88,000 unlawful attempts to obtain a firearm through firearm eligibility and compliance checks. Our growing strategy also includes bipartisan legislation signed by the governor requiring guns used in crimes to be entered into E-Trace, federal crime gun databases, and shell casings to be entered into the National Integrated Ballistic Information Network, as well as a new law creating gun intelligence sharing for law enforcement where ISP uses partnerships, crime analysis, and evidence-based practices to pursue justice in firearm-related shootings, homicides, and gun trafficking. This includes not only ballistic and E-trace data, but DNA evidence, latent fingerprints, firearms training data, which is all available in the ISP law enforcement portal. Along with major investments in forensics and the rebirth of the Illinois State Police Division of Criminal Investigation, this strategy to combat illegal firearms is evolving growing includes the timely dissemination of intelligence, like what we see here today, to investigators for investigative follow-up and coordinated prosecution to protect public safety and pursue justice. And thanks to the strong cooperative leadership of the Attorney General, supportive and considerate, who's always supportive and considerate of the challenges of daily law enforcement, thanks to him, we now have one more tool and one more chance to save a life being brought to bear on this noble effort. So with that, let me turn it over to Chief Mitchell Davis, past president of the Illinois Association of Chiefs of Police.
Thank you, Director. Good morning. I'm Mitchell Davis. I'm the police chief in the village of Hazelcrest. I'm also, as you heard, the immediate past president of the Illinois Association of Chiefs of Police. I would like to commend Attorney General Kwame Raoul on his continued leadership and foresight in addressing crime in the state of Illinois by providing resources and technical assistance to all law enforcement agencies. Crime Gun Connect is just the latest in a myriad of free resources that Attorney General Raoul has made available to all members of law enforcement in the state of Illinois. It was my pleasure during my presidency for the Illinois Association of Chiefs of Police to work with the Attorney General Raoul and Illinois State Police Director Brendan Kelly in providing law enforcement with a preview of this technology. It is truly an honor for me to be here today for the unveiling of Crime Gun Connect to the public. Attorney General Raoul's efforts in bringing Crime Gun Connect to fruition are important in more ways than one. First, it brings forth technology that will result in analytics that will make law enforcement investigative efforts more effective, more efficient, more expansive, and more comprehensive. The information that Crime Gun Connect provides to our investigators will allow them to be able to look beyond just an incident. Gun Crime Connect will allow those same investigators to look into layers of events that ultimately resulted in the representative incident that came to their community. Uncovering these precursory events will allow for collaboration between agencies that can help uncover root sources of illegal guns that ultimately end up in our communities. Secondly, it's free, which results in accessibility to all law enforcement agencies. Oftentimes, agencies faced with the most challenges are not able to adequately address those challenges, not because the resources aren't available, not because they don't want to, but because of financial constraints. This removes that barrier and provides an additional avenue for ensuring equitable policing in all communities. And finally, Crime Gun Connect is another tool in combating gun violence through helping law enforcement attack the purchase, distribution, and usage of illegal guns that are wreaking havoc across the state of Illinois and across our country. The Hazelcrest Police Department is already in the process of accessing Crime Gun Connect. And in my capacity as the past president of the South Suburban Association of Chiefs of Police, my capacity as the immediate past president of the Illinois Association of Chiefs of Police, as a board member of the International Association of Chiefs of Police, and as a board member for the National Organization of Black Law Enforcement Executives, I am going to implore my colleagues and agencies around the state of Illinois to make sure that they utilize Crime Gun Connect to assist in this component of Attorney General Raoul's statewide efforts in combating gun crimes and gun violence. I would like to thank Illinois State Police Director Brendan Kelly for his agency's willingness to provide oversight of this system. And again, I would like to thank Attorney General Kwame Raoul for his leadership and continued willingness to provide support for law enforcement across the state of Illinois through accessible resources to help combat gun violence through the tracing of legal guns. Thank you. Now I bring forth Chief Leo Smith of the Cook County Sheriff's Department.
Thank you, Mitch. First of all, I want to say on behalf of Sheriff Tom Dart, we have a friend and ally in the Attorney General, Kwame Raoul, and we are here to support this function. And also with the Director of the Illinois State Police, Brendan Kelly, thank you for what you're doing in getting this portal going. Now, I will tell you this, doing this for a long time, having gone over this with Adam previously, this helps Chicago Police, Cook County Sheriff's Police, the Illinois State Police, our brothers and sisters in the suburbs, and all the sheriff's offices throughout the state of Illinois to combat the violent crime, which the sheriff has always been pushing us to correct. The violent crime where people are shooting each other, we're talking about illegal gun owners trafficking guns so that people get hurt. This portal makes it easier for all of us, and Mitch Davis brought that up, Chief Davis, about when he said no cost. That is a big deal for us and everybody in the state. When there's no cost, people that have small agencies can use this portal. And if they have problems with shootings, they can do the same thing that we're doing. Our teams are out there all the time trying to stop gun trafficking, and this will enhance our effort to do that. So thank you for the Illinois State Police, Brian Kelly, and Attorney General Kwame Raoul in championing this. We're behind you 100%, and I can't wait to see how we can use this in the future and how our other sister agencies can use this. So with that being said, I'd like to introduce Dan Katowski.
Thank you so much, Chief. Thank you for your leadership. I'd like to thank Attorney General Raoul for his leadership and for everything he's done over the years to make sure that our state and our communities are safe from crime and in particular from gun violence. It's very important, the role that he's taken on here. I also want to thank Director Kelly for everything that he's done to make sure that we address the gun violence epidemic in our state. You know, my name is Dan Katowski. I'm the President and CEO of Kids Above All, and our mission is to place the safety, well-being, and education of all kids above everything else. And what we do is help to build better lives for kids who've been battling with poverty and violence and systemic inequities. And one of the ways in which we do that is make sure that we protect kids from gun violence, make sure that they're safe from gun violence. And why this is so important, what Attorney General Raoul is doing here today, is making sure that we address where the guns are coming from. Who made the gun? Who sold the gun? Who owned the gun? Oftentimes when we talk about children getting access to guns, teenagers getting access to guns, we don't talk about who makes it, who sells it, who owned the gun. And this is so important because children didn't make the guns. They didn't sell the guns. They didn't own the guns legally. But for some reason, they get in the hands of kids and teenagers all the time. So what's so important about 100,000 plus level of data here is we begin to tell that story that's not being told. Because we need to empower our children and our families and our communities to make sure that we go after people who are getting guns in the hands of children, in the hands of teenagers, because they're the ones who are suffering. They're suffering right now. And what this does, it gives law enforcement the tools to address gun trafficking, to address people who are getting these guns into the hands of children. And the fact is, gun violence is the number one cause of death for children in our country, the number one cause of death. And what Attorney General Raoul has done is said, look, I'm going to focus not just on the enforcement side, that's just not on the punishment side. I'm going to focus on who's responsible for making sure the guns are getting in the hands of children and how can we hold them accountable. Because once we start to do that, we're going to start to see a significant reduction in crime and violence and death in the state of Illinois. Thank you very much. Oh, Kim Smith.
Kim Smith from the Crime Lab is going to speak now.
I need no introduction. Thank you to the Illinois Attorney General's Office for inviting the University of Chicago Crime Lab to join you today to unveil this statewide crime gun tracing platform. My name is Kim Smith, and I'm the Director of Programs at the University of Chicago Crime Lab. We commend the bold leadership of the Attorney General and the more than 200 state law enforcement agencies who have partnered together to make this data available for the first time in our state through the new Crime Guns Connect platform. Make no mistake, gun violence is a public health crisis in America. In Illinois, nearly 1,800 lives were lost to gun violence in 2020 alone, and the toll of this violence continues to fall disproportionately on Black and Latinx residents. Gun violence is a public health crisis, and like any public health crisis, tackling gun violence requires that we address the root causes, which will require both long-term, sustained investments in improving education, reducing poverty, and eliminating segregation, but it will also require that we do what we can today to address gun violence and guarantee public safety as a basic right for all of our state's residents. A critical first step to reducing gun violence in the short run is to understand what's driving it. Without that understanding, we can't design policy solutions to save lives, and that is why today's announcement is so important. Crime Guns Connect will provide law enforcement agencies access to information on firearms recovered on crime scenes across the state. It will allow them to view information on what type of gun was used, where it was purchased, and the likelihood that straw purchasing was involved, aiding the ability of law enforcement to investigate firearms trafficking. Crime Guns Connect will also help law enforcement agencies identify patterns and trends in the sale of crime guns to answer important questions, like which gun models are most often used in crimes, which gun stores are a major source of crime guns, and how are crime guns coming into Illinois from out of state. Perhaps most importantly, Crime Guns Connect will allow the public to access a version of this gun tracing information, providing transparency and accountability for both our leaders and the gun industry. At the Crime Lab, we've seen the power of making data accessible to policymakers and the public. In 2017, we partnered with the City of Chicago and the Joyce Foundation to produce a public analysis of the city's gun trace data. The report revealed that 40% of Chicago crime guns were actually originally purchased in the state of Illinois, prompting in part the state legislature to tighten regulation of Illinois gun dealers. And just last year, we again partnered with the City of Chicago to create the nation's first violence reduction dashboard. The dashboard shares real-time data on violence trends to help city agencies and community-based organizations better target their violence prevention strategies. Today's announcement builds on these efforts and is a critical step towards addressing Illinois' gun violence crisis. But Crime Guns Connect will only be successful if law enforcement agencies opt in. We join the Attorney General's team in calling on law enforcement agencies across the state to do exactly that. Help your own investigators cut down on firearms trafficking, help policymakers design laws to limit straw purchasing, help researchers better understand underground gun markets, help all of us in the fight to save lives and make our state safer for everyone. Thank you. And with that, I will introduce Casey from the Joyce Foundation.
Good morning, everyone. So good to be here, and thank you to Attorney General Raoul for hosting us here today and for your extraordinary leadership over the years in making our community safer from gun violence. My name is Casey Altiero, and I am the Chief External Affairs Officer at the Joyce Foundation here in Chicago. The Joyce Foundation is a nonpartisan private foundation that invests in public policies and strategies to advance racial equity and economic mobility for the next generation in the Great Lakes region. For more than 25 years, the Foundation's Gun Violence Prevention and Justice Reform Program has focused on building safe and just communities in our region by supporting research, policy development, and policy implementation. One area we have focused on in recent years is firearms tracing. A gun that is recovered at the scene of a crime can provide invaluable information about gun crime, the source of crime guns, and illegal gun trafficking in the community. But that information and all the benefits it can provide can only be realized if law enforcement departments are, one, tracing crime guns, two, sharing the data about these traces with their peers, and three, taking the time to analyze and act on the information, on what the information tells them. Even though the ATF offers a crime gun tracing service, E-Trace, to every state and local law enforcement agency in the country, the unfortunate reality is that E-Trace is widely underused by police departments, including here in Illinois. As of September 2021, only 8,900 of the more than 18,000 law enforcement agencies nationwide were using E-Trace. And only about 20% of law enforcement agencies have agreed to share their tracing data with their peers. In recent years, the Joyce Foundation has supported projects to educate law enforcement agencies about the immense value of firearms tracing, recruit more agencies to use the E-Trace platform and to share the data they gather, improve the E-Trace system itself and support and improve ATF's management of the tool, and fund research based on the tracing data collected to inform policymakers, law enforcement, media, and other stakeholders on how we would further refine ways to reduce gun violence in our communities. To that last point, as Kim mentioned, the Joyce Foundation supported two studies at the University of Chicago Crime Lab, which in 2014 and 2017 collaborated with the Chicago's mayor's office to release two reports offering comprehensive information about how illegal guns entered the city and surrounding areas. These reports allowed police to identify the sources of crime guns, which led to more targeted enforcement, and they provided policymakers with key information that subsequently led to the enactment of Illinois' new firearm dealer licensing law. This was only possible because of gun tracing. Now with Crime Gun Connect, the Illinois Attorney General, Illinois State Police, and law enforcement agencies across the state will be better equipped to use and take advantage of platforms like eTrace and fully realize the benefits that gun tracing can provide in reducing gun violence in our communities. And it's not just our state law enforcement agencies that will benefit from today's announcement. Crime Gun Connect is a significant advancement for the field that we believe has the potential to be replicated in other states in the region and the country. Adoption in other states would benefit us all. The flow of crime guns respects no state borders, and that reality requires the federal government and every state in the country to do their part in stemming this tide. We strongly believe that platforms like Crime Gun Connect are an important and necessary step to making our communities safer and doing so in a fair and just way. Thank you again, Mr. Attorney General, for inviting me to join you today, and congratulations to you and your team for developing and launching Crime Gun Connect. And with that, I'll turn it over to Valerie Burgess at Moms Demand Action. Thank you.
Thank you, and good morning, everybody. I am Valerie Burgess, and I am the co-chapter lead for the State of Illinois Moms Demand Action for Gun Sense in America. I am also a Survivor Fellow with the Everytown Survivor Network. I'd like to thank Attorney General Raoul for always being a gun sense champion. I first met Attorney General Raoul a few years ago when he was announcing his candidacy, but he has always been a gun sense champion, which is important to an organization like Moms Demand. But more importantly, I stand before you today as a parent. I stand before you as a mother who had to bury her only child. My son, Craig Williams, was born January 27, 1990, and he was shot and killed on the south side of Chicago to December 2018, 2013. To date, almost 9 years after his murder, his case is still unsolved. So this is extremely personal for me, because any tool that helps law enforcement solve murders in this city and in this state is an important tool and one that we all will embrace. I'm not a member of law enforcement. I'm not a politician. As I said, I'm a mother. And I'm a mother who will forever grieve. My son was 23 years old when he was shot and killed, so he's forever 23. He left behind two children who were too young to know and understand what a father's love does for them in their life. So they're gonna grow up without a father. So once again, my thanks to Attorney General Raoul for always being a gun sense champion. And as a representative of Moms Demand Action for Gun Sense in America, as a representative of Everytown for Gun Safety, we throw our full support behind any measure that reduces crime and violence in this country and in this city. Thank you. And I will hand it back to Attorney General Raoul.
Before I take questions, I want to thank two entities in particular, again, that gave us a vision to do this. One, Everytown for Gun Safety, who's introduced the concept of crime gun tracing in different municipalities in different states. So we saw the vision of that prior to taking this on here. They have indicated to us that ours is the most state-of-the-art in the nation. And of course, the Chicago Police Department that engaged in crime gun tracing some years ago. So this is a supplement to what the Chicago Police Department has already started doing on a local level, but we're taking it statewide and combining it with the state police's other tools to really be able to get the type of data that we need and the data sharing that we need to really crack down on gun trafficking. We know we don't grow guns in the city of Chicago or in a lot of municipalities that suffer the worst gun violence. They're coming from somewhere. there are people who are specifically knowingly trafficking guns into the hands of people they know will do harm with them. And so we're after not only the person that pulls the trigger, but the person that makes sure that the shooter gets the gun. We've been in touch with the city of Chicago, and they've committed collaboration to working on this statewide tracing effort. And so with that, I open up to any questions.
Attorney General, because the ATF doesn't keep digitized records, with this 100,000 database, do you have a sense of what percentage of the universe of guns out there in Illinois this represents?
Of the...
In other words, are there a lot of guns that aren't covered by this out there?
Yeah, it's difficult to know. We're encouraging, as said by several of the speakers, we're encouraging as many law enforcement agencies to participate in the e-trace and such that we can have as complete data as we can. So the effort, the reason why we're here today announcing, we could simply just launch Crime Gun Connect and not announce it, right? But it's important to lift it up, to lift up the value of it, to let all of our law enforcement partners know of the importance of participating with the ATF and participating with us with Crime Gun Connect.
Attorney General Raoul, there's been federal regulations on, as kind of dictate why some of these records are only in paper form. How is Crime Connect, under the state law here, obviously, you're all state officials, getting around any kind of federal regulations that bars the public from obtaining data about, crime guns or, converting it from paper to digital?
Well, as we said, we are going to have a public-facing platform that's just going to show trends and things like that, but the actual Crime Gun Connect platform will be accessible by law enforcement only.
Okay. And also with e-trace, sounds like a lot of law enforcement agencies aren't utilizing it to its full potential. Do you know why that is?
In our communications, and we've been trying to do as much of an outreach effort as possible, some don't realize how simple it is to opt in. And we're trying to do our part, all of us collectively, and count on you guys to help us out on this. And that's part of the reason we're here.
So you're not running into any philosophical roadblocks?
No, I don't think we've.
Awareness. Are these actual screen grabs or mock-ups of the system?
Won't you explain it?
This is an actual screen grab. Of course, the specific information related to this particular case has been anonymized because of restrictions in federal law that preclude us from sharing data outside of law enforcement. But the screenshot up is what an actual law enforcement officer will see when he or she sits down at his workstation and accesses the system.
And just a question on the data points that get inserted. Is the idea here that Batavia Police Department, the Champaign Police Department, do their homework, they collect it, they input it into the system, and then everybody can share it? Or is it we go and request things from the federal government, we get information from there, and then because they can't digitize it, we're digitizing that data kind of piecemeal? Or is it both of those?
It's really the former. We would encourage every police department throughout the state to participate in e-trace, and when they recover a gun that's been utilized in the commission of a crime, to submit that firearm through the e-trace system. When they do so, so long as they've opted into the collective data sharing function, all of the other law enforcement agencies in the state will be able to see that record, and it will be populated in the system that we've developed.
And so then what exactly is the digitizing issue that has been an issue up to this point? If you can do all of what you just described, What has been the shortcoming here before?
So what an agency in that situation would actually receive from the ATF is essentially a PDF of a paper record that includes all of the basic biographical and geographic information that the ATF was able to deliver. But you can imagine, you know, for a department that's accumulated many of them, the upshot is that they would print it out and the pile would slowly grow, where the data would be entered into a spreadsheet and the lines on the spreadsheet would grow. What we've done here is incorporate all of that data into a format that will allow every law enforcement agency in the state, regardless of their level of infrastructure or sophistication, to access the information the same way they would through a Google search.
And digitizing that ATF information, there's no issues there?
No.
Okay. I don't want to dominate. Can I ask one more question? On that screen here where we see the instances on the west side, just to kind of put a finer point on this, each of those white squares are cases where the gun came from Indianapolis, is that right? This is an actual case?
That's correct.
And when, do you have any idea when this was?
Or? 2019.
2019, okay, thank you.
Attorney General Raoul, kind of off topic, do you have any reaction to Tom DeVore winning the Republican nomination for Attorney General? What is his, what is him winning the Republican primary say about the state of the Republican Party, and what does that mean for you going into November?
Well, first of all, congratulations to Tom DeVore. Listen, in my role, I think in the role of Attorney General, it's important not only for me in this state, but for my colleagues in other states, to try to be as nonpartisan as possible. And in our law enforcement role, for example, I don't choose which state's attorneys I collaborate with based on party affiliation. I don't choose which police chiefs I collaborate with based on party affiliation. I count many of them who may be Republicans as my personal friends who I've worked with on this project, as well as on making sure we get relief to those who are addicted on opioids and trying to combat organized retail crime. We've collaborated, and we haven't talked a second about Tom DeVore or partisan politics. I look forward to having to being able to compare my record serving as Attorney General to Mr. DeVore and whoever was may have been nominated, but with any other parties.
It's just that he's been kind of a frequent foe of the Attorney General's office with, you know, his lawsuits and the Attorney General having to defend Governor Pritzker, the Attorney General's office having to defend Governor Pritzker with that. So,
yeah, no, I understand your question, and believe me, I would have rather used those resources on some of the other things that I mentioned to keep on continuously making successfully the same argument over and over again about mitigations that we put in place to save lives. What we're doing here is aimed at saving lives. What we do with regards to opioid abatement is aimed at saving lives, not drawing attention to ourselves. We're hosting a press conference here not to draw attention to ourselves, but to get the word out there to law enforcement partners and to the public at large. That we need to focus not just on the shooter, but on those who are trafficking guns to the shooter. Thank you.